The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment and contains views, opinions, commentaries, and content that may offend some subscribers of this show. Listener discretion is advised.
It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
Gotta be the man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 3729288. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 3729288. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god.
J.B.L. J-B-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
Comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
Don't miss out on any of the action. Download our app on the App Store, Google Play, and the official website of HEW Entertainment. Once you download and install it, you'll get caught up on news, YouTube videos, and more. Download it now.
Get up, get up, get up. Drop the bombshell. Get up, get up. This is out of control. Get up, get up, get up. Drop the bombshell. Get up, get up. Now look who's coming, yeah, look who's back. Quick drop the bombshell straight to the track. The 21st century killing machine burned on the inside of 5-headed team. Now I'm not the same, yeah, cause you're not the same. And you're not the same, yeah, cause I'm not the same. And we're not the same, this could never be the same. And we just wanna survive.
Get up, get up, get up.
Drop the bombshell.
Get up, get up.
This is out of control.
Get up, get up, get up.
Drop the bombshell.
Get up, get up.
Get up, get up, get up.
Drop the bombshell.
Get up, get up.
This is out of control.
Get up, get up, get up.
Drop the bombshell.
Get up, get up. Now you wanna save us and you want it all. Want the transmit cause you want the call. And you want the one that made the worlds collide. But since that has happened, we've grown twice in size.
We're not the same. We're not the same. We're not the same. We're not the same.
Get up, get up, get up.
Drop the bombshell.
Get up, get up.
This is out of control.
Drop the bombshell.
Get up, get up.
Get
up, get up, get up.
Drop the bombshell.
Get up, get up.
This is out of control.
Get up, get up, get up.
Drop the bombshell.
Get up, get up.
As much as it pains me to have to say this on my radio show this week, the Dudley Boys have called it a career. They are done this past Monday on Raw, coming out and confirming for us all after a series of tweets and Instagram posts that they are done with their 20-year run with professional wrestling after having won over 20 championships. That's one for every 20 years the Dudley Boys have been involved in the wrestling industry. Congratulations to both Bubba Ray and D-Von Dudley for an incredible career. 20 years they have given wrestling fans, and the wrestling fans showing their appreciation. In Brooklyn, New York, the same place they did SummerSlam, is where the Dudley Boys announced their retirement 1 week after having their final tag team match as competitors in the ring against Neville and Sin Cara, I do believe. It kind of really shocked me that the Dudley Boys called it a career after 20 years, especially after coming back last year. They came back and they allowed they were going to do the big thing and win the tag team titles within 1 year of their return, and they didn't have things go their way, apparently. They alluded that in their promo this past Monday on Raw. That's what was interesting about the whole circumstance, was that Bubba Ray and D-Von Dudley were pretty blunt about what was actually going on behind closed doors. They didn't kayfabe anything in the circumstance that had befallen them. Apparently things had not gone their way. Whatever they meant by that, obviously there was a lot of backstage politics they were referring to. And then here come Anderson and Gallows, and pretty much used the tables to their advantage. The Dudleys had set up to put the Shining Stars through, Primo and Epico. And Anderson and Gallows, the club, take advantage of an opportunity to make names for themselves by taking out one of the most legendary teams. And in Michael Cole's estimation, from his standpoint, where he chose to look at it, the greatest tag team in wrestling today. I don't know if they're the greatest tag team in wrestling today, because you have Demolition holding the world tag team titles for a record 478 days in the New Day, with 365 days under their belt. So with that being said, it's going to be argued for a really long time, if the Dudley Boys, whether or not we're the greatest tag team in wrestling history. But everywhere they competed statistically, they won the championship for every major promotion they had worked with, spanning anywhere from WWE to WCW to ECW to even TNA. They had won the tag team titles, and they won the WCW tag team titles when they had worked under contract with WWE, but still, in the record books, it'll go down in history as a WCW tag team title win for the Dudleys, holding every major tag team title they were eligible to have competed for every major promotion. I remember watching them on Friday nights on then TNN, which is now Spike TV, and watching the one-hour ECW TV deal. And when they had announced they were leaving ECW for WWE, and they allowed they were going to take the ECW tag team titles, to the dismay of Joel Gertner and Joey Styles doing commentary, and lay them at the feet of the McMahon family. It was in that same night, on that same broadcast, Tommy Dreamer and Raven won the tag team titles back from the Dudley Boys. I forget who they faced to actually win the tag team titles to begin with, but it was a really unique and very authentic concept to see the Dudley Boys involved with. And I remember watching them back in the early 90s, back as far as 96, 97. I used to watch a lot of footage of them, and I'll never forget everything, every moment they created. They created history known the world over, like matches like the TLC match with Edge Christian and the Hardy Boys. They really revolutionized the Attitude Era, really put that on notice for professional wrestling, and it will be debated whether or not without the Dudley Boys the Attitude Era would have been as successful as what it was. You know, you had The Rock and Stone Cold Steve Austin, but on the other side of the coin, if you had on the head side of the coin The Rock and Steve Austin, on the tail side of that you had teams like the Dudley Boys and Edge and Christian, who really went the distance for WWE. So they definitely did create a lot of history known the world over that people still talk about to this very day, which is pretty amazing, because some things happen in professional wrestling that a lot of people just tend to forget about, but they're never going to forget about teams like Edge and Christian, the Dudley Boys, the Hardy Boys, their contributions they gave us to professional wrestling that went on for years and years and years. And I guess, you know, it was just time for the Dudley Boys to call it a career. Now, I don't really agree with how the retirement of the Dudley Boys were handled, because of how they said goodbye after a 20-year career had apparently not gone the way they had wanted it to. Although they did allow that they had a lot of great moments and a lot of things they'll never forget happened to them throughout their illustrious careers, having wrestled for every major promotion. Didn't really agree with how they were sent out. They should have just put the Shining Stars through the table for the sake of putting someone through the table one final time after having allowed. They didn't want anything to do with table or be remembered for having put people through tables throughout their 20-year career. They wanted to be known as legends, but regardless if they put people through tables or not, they're going to go down in history for being legends regardless if they put people through tables or not. So that really didn't have anything to do with it But they should have just put the Shining Stars, Primo, and Epico through tables. Nobody really cares about their Caribbean history and cares really about the Shining Stars and where they're going to go with their careers, if anything. Being put through tables by the Dudley Boys is a prestigious honor and would have really made the Shining Stars into bigger superstars than what they would have been if they would have actually got the better of the Dudley Boys. You didn't have to have Anderson and Gallows come out. I mean, their program with the New Day was sufficient enough. Enough was enough for Carlton and Anderson. They didn't need to come out and do what they did. It was just absolutely ridiculous how Gallows and Anderson actually got away with doing what they did and treating the Dudley Boys the way they did. They really got all over by the Brooklyn crowd. The crowd was all over them because of what they did. And that was to be expected because people in Brooklyn, places like Brooklyn and Philadelphia, are just die-hard hardcore wrestling fans. They know the wrestling heritage, especially in places like Philadelphia. And if that would have been in Philadelphia, that would have happened. And Anderson and Gallows, the club, were actually lucky that it didn't happen in Philadelphia, because if it did, the crowd would have rioted and they would have just been all over Anderson and Gallows. They would have had to put hoods over their heads just to get them out of Brooklyn because of what, or out of Philadelphia rather, because of what would have happened. There would have been a downright riot because of what would have happened to the Dudley Boys. It would have just been ridiculous. Ridiculously crazy, if you would, if that would have happened in Philadelphia. So they were lucky that it happened in Brooklyn where it did and when it did, under the circumstances that it did, because in no way, shape, nor form, if that would have happened anywhere,